Now that we have covered a few special issues related to calculating baseline equivalence, let's turn to statistical adjustments and the role they play in the baseline equivalence standard. Upon determining that a study is an RCT with high attrition, or compromised random assignment, or a QED, the WWC assesses baseline equivalence. Recall from earlier in the module that the effect size determines whether a study's impact analysis requires a statistical adjustment for a covariate. Let's summarize the requirements for statistical covariate adjustments. If the effect size for the analytic sample is less than the absolute value of 0.05 standard deviations, then the analysis does not require a statistical covariate adjustment. The highest possible rating for a study in this situation is meets WWC group design standards with reservations. Effect sizes greater than 0.05 standard deviations and less than or equal to 0.25 standard deviations require statistical covariate adjustment. If the study uses a statistical adjustment, then it can meet WWC group design standards with reservations. Finally, if baseline differences are greater than 0.25 standard deviations, they cannot meet WWC group design standards with reservations, even if they adjust for the covariate. Requirements for statistical adjustments also differ across protocols. Protocols that allow equivalence in one domain to affect equivalence in other domains also tend to require statistical adjustments across domains. Protocols that use an outcome-by-outcome approach require only an adjustment for the pretest of the same outcome measure. What statistical adjustments does the WWC consider appropriate? Without getting into any technical details of statistical adjustment methods, acceptable methods of statistical adjustment include a regression covariate adjustment, including a hierarchical linear model, or analysis of covariance on COVA. Both are acceptable adjustments. Unacceptable statistical adjustments include gain scores, difference in differences adjustments, and repeated measures analysis of variance on NOVA. These methods do not provide acceptable adjustments for the WWC. They raise a concern because they assume a fixed relationship between the pretest and the post-test. When deciding whether a statistical adjustment is acceptable, the WWC requires that the authors estimate the relationship from the data rather than assuming or imposing it based on the analytic approach. These methods, ANOVA, difference in differences, repeated measures ANOVA, and gain scores, are acceptable ways to estimate impacts, but the WWC does not consider their statistical adjustments for baseline differences acceptable. Studies that use these analytic approaches and have baseline differences larger than 0.05 standard deviations do not meet WWC group design standards. However, low attrition RCTs and other studies with baseline differences less than 0.05 standard deviations that report impacts calculated using these methods can meet WWC group design standards.